People say social media has made us ruder as a society. Round of applause. How many of y'all think social media has made us ruder? Okay. A good amount. I don't think so. I set you up to fail there. That was rude of me. I don't think it's made us ruder. I think we've always been rude. We've always been rude as a society. We just have more outlets for it now. Like, yeah, now you want to be rude, you can write something nasty on somebody's Facebook page, or a bunch of people go troll someone on Twitter. Used to be a bunch of people wanted to troll someone. They had to do something like burn a cross in someone's yard. Which, if I'm being totally honest, I will take nasty Facebook comments 10 times out of 10. You burn a cross in my yard, it's just like, what? For real? Shit, I'm watching Scandal right now. Shit. I'm gonna come out here and get a hose and put this out. Thanks a lot, you ruined my yard. Have to go to the hardware store tomorrow and get some mulch, and let's be honest, chances are pretty good somebody at the hardware store might be in on this mystery. Oh, you mean to tell me you didn't see anybody come in here and buy like 2 2x4s and some kerosene? We've always been rude. We have more outlets for it now. The song is the same. The instruments are just different. Like, we've always been rude. Just look at shit we've done. Slavery. One of the rudest things you could do to a person. Such a rude thing to do to a person, to enslave them. It ranks right up there with, like, changing lanes without signaling. I'm saying, build a time machine, go back to, like, Georgia in the 1700s, go get a slave, bring them to present-day Georgia, show them, like, a wealthy white couple sitting on their porch as a Jamaican woman rocks their baby to sleep, and some Latin guys work in their yard. And that slave will look at you and be like, oh, would you look at that? You finally got the octoroons working in the fields. Good for you. We tried forever. It's obvious nepotism, but, you know, hard to unionize when you're a slave. What? No, they're not slaves. Oh, sorry. I didn't realize those were Americans doing those jobs. Well. Oh, so you still got foreigners raising your children and tending to your fields, but it's not slavery. No, they're not slaves like you. I have a name. It's Jefferson. All right, Jefferson, they're not like you, all right? They're not slaves. Right, but they're not Americans. I mean, can they vote or anything? No, they can't vote, and they're not Americans. But you know what? They get to live in America, and we pay them, and they're free. So, like, 3 out of 5 things is not that bad. Oh, yeah, no, it's not that bad being 3/5 of you. Well, thanks for bringing me here, future man. I'm gonna find that time machine and leave now. You're gonna go back to your own time? Oh, no, fuck that. No. I'm gonna go to dinosaur times. Might get a blowjob from a brontosaurus. They don't eat meat, but they love the taste, if you catch my drift. Oh, what? I'm not supposed to know what dinosaurs are because I was just a slave? Fuck you, man. I was a doctor in my country. Check your privilege. And that's the story of Jefferson Goodlove, the first man to ever have sex with a dinosaur. But I bet you didn't learn about him in school, which is why we have Black History Month.